are redeemed by the blood of Jesus. Again, all these religious thoughts and all that, you know, you got to find out your sin before you can talk to God, before God can hear you and all that, you know, and your unconfessed sin, right? That's why I'm telling you, this kind of consciousness can rob you of a prayer life. You got to know that you're forgiven of all your sins. Amen. And thank God for that. True confession is homologia, to say the same thing with God about our sins. What did God say about our sins in the new covenant? They are all forgiven by Jesus' blood. Confess that. The more you believe that, you won't fall into sin. I'm telling you. Because you won't be sin conscious. Before you fall into sin, you are sin conscious.
So the true church is going to be permeated by the perceptible presence of God. It's going to be glorious. It's not going to have spot or wrinkle. A spot, I would understand, to be unconfessed sin. And a wrinkle is some misformation of the church. It's going to be without either. It's going to be holy and without blemish.
And because hyper grace teachers say all your future sins are already forgiven, then the Holy Spirit will never convict you of sin because God doesn't see it. And if all your sins are already forgiven, then you never have to confess your sin because it's already forgiven. And it's impossible that anything you do could ever change your relationship with God, and you see how this can open the door to sin and deception and complacency. So they preach against repentance, they preach against conviction of sin, they preach against the need to confess our sins. And now here's what's interesting. The leading grace preachers, they will all say this is not a license to sin. They will all say grace empowers you not to sin. The problem is the other things they preach with it, the additions, the distortions, the mixture, the poison. It does give people a license to sin, and it takes away the dealings of God in our lives.